Hello students, how are you all? Hope you all are good. I, Abhishek Tripathi, going to teach you chapter 1st of class 10th maths, that is real number. In our previous video, we have discussed about the types of numbers, set of numbers, natural numbers, whole numbers, prime, co-prime, composite and so on. In that particular video, we have discussed about the basics of numbers, or you may say recall of your previous class studies about the number. Today we are going to start the new topic of our class. That very first topic of your chapter 1st real number is Euclid division lemma. Okay, Euclid division lemma. This is your first topic of the book, of the chapter, real number. Okay, Euclid division lemma. We will discuss these three words one by one. Euclid was a mathematician. He was a mathematician. Division simply means repeated, or you can say repeat subtraction. So Euclid was a mathematician. Division is nothing but a repeated subtraction. A lemma. Lemma is a proven statement, already proven statement. Statement which is being used to prove another statement. It is a proven statement which we use, which we use for proving another statement. Okay. Now, before going into the Euclid division lemma, I want to explain you the concept of division. Explain, not exact word for explaining. Means we will recall the division, okay, and we will have some conditions during the division, okay. So very first, the name of chapter, real number. Real number means any number which can be represented on number line is called real number. किसी भी number को अगर आप number line पर represent कर सकते हैं तो वो क्या कहलाता है आपका real number, okay. सो रियल नंबर आपको पता है कि एनी नंबर विच कैन बी रिप्रेजेंटेड ऑन वेयर नंबर लाइन इज कॉल्ड रियल नंबर. ओके, दुनिया के किसी भी नंबर को अगर आप नंबर लाइन पर रिप्रेजेंट कर सकते हैं तो दैट पर्टिकुलर नंबर इज कंसीडर टू बी अ रियल नंबर. नाउ इन दिस चैप्टर व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द यूक्लिड डिवीजन लेमा. सो वेरी फर्स्ट वी विल ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ डिवीजन. ओके, so let's take an example. For example, if I'm dividing 12 by 2 means you have to divide the 12 by the number 2. Okay, let's do the division. 2 12 2 6 12. Okay. How much table you have to utter? You have to utter the table either equals to the dividend or less than to the dividend. या तो 12 के बराबर होना चाहिए या 12 से छोटा होना चाहिए. So that is how much you have to utter the table. 2 6 12 12 minus 12, that is 0. Now the dividend is 12. Divisor is 2. Quotient is quotient is 6 and remainder is 0. Okay. The divisor is 2, dividend is 12, quotient is 6 and remainder is 0. This is the simple process of the division. Now, take some more examples. Okay. If I want to check the division, that whether I have done a correct division or not, so what I will do, I have a formula. That formula is dividend is equals to dividend is equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Let's check this division. 12 is equals to 2 was the divisor, 6 was the quotient and remainder was 0. So 12 is equals to 6 to the 12 means we have done a correct division. Okay, we have done a correct division. Now, so this is the method of checking the division and this is the process of division. Which number is being divided is called dividend. Which number is dividing the dividend is called divisor. The number of subtractions we can have is called quotient and the remainder is called the remainder, means number which left after the division is called remainder. Now, please remember this, please remind this and please pay enough attention towards this formula. This will help us to solve so many questions. And okay, chalte hain. Let's take an example for better understanding of division. Okay, for example, if I am dividing 30 by 3, this is my first division. I am dividing 31 by 3, this is my second division. I am dividing 32 by 3, this is third division. And the last, 33 divided by 3. We will have one-to-one division of each number. 30 is being divided by 3. So 3 ones are 3 minus 0, again 0, 3 zeros are 0, subtracted, remainder is 0. In this division, 31 is being divided by 3, 3 ones are 3, subtracted, 0, 1, 3 zeros are 0, minus 1. This is again a division. Now, 32 is being divided by 3, 3 ones are 3, minus 0, 2, 3 zeros are 0, minus 2. 33 is being divided by 3, 3 ones are 3, minus 0, again 3, 3 ones are 3, remainder 0. Now, pay a keen attention to each division which I have done on the board. The very first division, 30 is being divided by 3. 30 is being divided by 3. So, we are getting the remainder 0 and quotient 10. Okay. Now, 31 is being divided by 3. We are getting the remainder 1 and quotient 10. When 32 is being divided by, we are getting the remainder 2 and the quotient 10. Now, if I am dividing 33, I am getting the remainder 0 and the quotient 11. Okay. Now, so can you understand, can you guess what is the exact pattern here? Okay. In this division. So, let's check the division. Okay. So, as I have told you the formula, dividend is equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. 30 was the dividend, 3 was the divisor and 10 is the quotient and remainder is 0. In this, 31 is the dividend and 3 is the divisor and 10 is the dividend and 1 is the remainder. Now, 32 was the dividend, 3 was the divisor and 10 was the quotient and 2 is the remainder. In this, 33 is equals to 3 was the divisor and 11 was the quotient and 0 is remainder. Okay. So, can you see a pattern that when you are dividing 30, you are getting remainder 0. When you are getting 31, you are getting remainder 1. When you are dividing 32, we are getting the remainder 2. But when we are dividing 33, we are getting remainder 0. It means when you are dividing any number by 3, you can get the maximum remainder is 2. The maximum remainder is 2. अगर आप किसी नंबर को 3 से डिवाइड कर रहे हो तो आपको मैक्सिमम रिमाइंडर कितना मिलने वाला है 2. ओके अगर आप किसी नंबर को 3 से डिवाइड कर रहे हैं और रिमाइंडर 2 मिल रहा है, इसका मतलब क्या हुआ? इट सिंपली मीन्स द रिमाइंडर कैन नेवर बी मोर देन द डिवाइजर. रिमाइंडर कभी भी डिवाइजर से बड़ा नहीं होगा. अब यहाँ पे 32 तक तो ठीक था, रिमाइंडर 2 मिला. जैसे ये 30+3 दैट इज 33 हुआ तो कोसेंट की वैल्यू 1 इंक्रीज हो गई और रिमाइंडर कितना मिल गया आपको? 0. सो अगर हम इसको ऐसे लिख लें पैटर्न के रूप में, 31 इज इक्वल टू 3 इंटू 10+1, 32 इज इक्वल टू 10+2, 33 इज इक्वल टू 3 इंटू 11+0. ओके दिस इज द simple division which we have done according to the given numbers. Now the Euclid division lemma, what it states, ध्यान से देखिए कि division आपको समझ में आया होगा. अब देखिए इसको ध्यान से. Any real number b when divided by a gives the quotient q and the remainder r. ठीक है, अगर आप इसको ध्यान से देखो तो remainder minimum 0 and maximum 2. Maximum 2 क्यों हो रहा है? क्योंकि हम 3 से डिवाइड कर रहे हैं. अगर हम 4 से डिवाइड कर रहे होते तो मैक्सिमम कितना जाता? 3. मिनिमम तो 0 ही रहता, मैक्सिमम कितना जाता? 3. 5 से डिवाइड करते तो कितना होता मिनिमम? 0. मैक्सिमम कितना होता? 4. तो जो भी डिवाइजर होगा उससे एक कम. So whatever remainder you will get the remainder less than 1 from the divisor. Okay, divisor से हमेशा क्या होगा? एक कम होगा. So Euclid division lemma states any real number b which when divided by a gives you the quotient q and the remainder r, where r is always smaller than a. A is what? The divisor. And greater or equals to 0. कभी भी आप किसी रियल नंबर b को a से डिवाइड करोगे तो आपको क्या मिलेगा? q कोशेंट में और r क्या मिलेगा? रिमाइंडर. रिमाइंडर कभी भी a से बड़ा नहीं होगा, याद रखिएगा. और r रिमाइंडर कभी भी 0 से छोटा नहीं होगा. 0 के बराबर हो सकता है, 0 से बड़ा हो सकता है. तो अगर हम कंडीशन लगाएं तो r इज ऑलवेज स्मॉलर देन a एंड greater r equals to 0. This is what Euclid division lemma states. Euclid division lemma क्या बोलता है? Any real number b which when divided by real number a will give you the quotient q and the remainder 0. And the value of remainder can never be more than the divisor. Divisor से हमेशा एक कम रहेगा. And the value of remainder can be equals to 0 or greater than 0. तो अगर एक लाइन में कहें कि Euclid division lemma क्या है, तो अगर किसी रियल नंबर b को आप a से डिवाइड करोगे तो आपको जो quotient मिलेगा वो q कहलाएगा और जो r मिलेगा वो remainder कहलाएगा. और r की वैल्यू कभी भी डिवाइजर मतलब a से ज़्यादा नहीं होगी और 0 या 0 से बड़ी हो सकती है. समझ में आई आप सबको बात? So hope you all like the video. आज के लिए इतना ही. अगले वीडियो में हम आपको इसके आगे चर्चा करेंगे. For more videos, please do like, share and subscribe. Thank you.